Patty seconded it.
I'm sorry. All those in favor? Anyone opposed? Do I hear a motion to approve the minutes?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Everyone in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Then they're approved. Old business. MAPCO property, non-compliance, follow-up on landscape compliance, and confirmed trees have been pruned and planted and completed. Mike Berkeley.
I haven't seen any pruning. Have they said, did they say something to you about the pruning?
I believe that one of the meetings a long time ago, you were going to contact their guy and see when he was planning on pruning. I got to check for the...
I was supposed to call him?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
But,
Who do I call?
I've got his number in there. I'll get it for you and you can...
Is it a landscape?
Wayne Hall studied at the last meeting that he and Mike Berkeley were going to set up a meeting to supervise the pruning.
I'd be glad to call him.
Yeah.
I just need his information. Sorry.
Well, no, no, I think both of you together were going to do it, so...
I've got the number. We can call. Set it up.
Been on for a long time, too.
You're muttering. Update, okay. Any more discussion on 5.1? 5.2, update on the roadscapes project, 196 Junction, and the associated dedication.
I'll give you the update. Talked to the landscaper today, Paul Stacy with LSI. And I think y'all have probably noticed the brown spots out there where the planting will take place. Have you talked to him at all, Mike, about him sending pictures and stuff out to approve the plant list?
The person that hunts down the plants, the buyer for LSI, mm-hmm. contacted us, and because there were some questions on availability on some of those plants. And there's a spirea on there, Virginia spirea, that's actually an endangered species. And believe it or not, I had nothing to do with that. But when he designed it in, I guess the idea was that, you know, it'd make it unique or something, but it's a big white blooming, you know. The numbers out there, you can't find them. So, but I told him I would help him as much as possible. That's the last I heard.
Okay. He said he would hopefully get those out to this week, and hopefully, if that's approved by you, Mike, then he'll be ready to yeah. start planting. And said he hoped to have the planting yeah. done by the end of the month.
Good.
And the brown spots are where they're where they, the grass.
Right. Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm.
What about the wording for the sign?
That's up to y'all. I'm leaving that pretty well how y'all would like to have it worded.
I thought we had.
We had one.
We had some changes to be made, and have those changes been made?
I haven't been told of any myself.
I'll look back and find
okay.
the wording.
Just email it to me, if you don't mind.
Okay.
So we need, once the wording is determined, we need Mr. Hall to go ahead and order the sign.
Yes.
Okay. So.
Did y'all like the rendering that Andrew Krager had presented?
I think we all worked on that and liked what he, didn't we approve that?
Uh-huh.
There was a height issue for me. Did we get a final? Because I missed.
I think all that's corrected. We'll make sure before we put the sign up.
Okay.
So if we can get the correct wording, make sure the height is good, because he came up with this whole new design that looked more like, because we were talking about just having a metal pole we would not like, so that's gone. And update on the use of the funds from the tree bank for this?
The tree bank will be paying for the whole project, and then we will be billing TDOT back for the 80%.
And then trees and sign, or just is it sign included?
That's still a gray area. You know, we may have to talk to Tom more about how we. But I don't believe the sign's going to cost that much money. I don't believe it's. Wasn't we talking less than $300, somewhere around that?
We talked about that last month. And there was a. And, no, that's okay. No. Last meeting. I'm sorry.
How long was it?
As long as it takes for TDOT to get that money back to us.
Well, we've been waiting quite a while on this resurfacing money. I understand it's supposed to come back this month, and that's $214,000 we're waiting on right now, so.
But it could take a while.
It could take a while.
It could take a year.
So that's the reason that I've asked not to spend any money out of the tree bank fund until we have enough money available, so we'll have enough money available to pay for the whole project. And then we'll, our 20% will come out of there as well, and then we'll make the wait on the reimbursement.
I know that you have assured me that that money is coming back into that tree fund, but I would still like a paper trail of the money going out and coming back in.
Okay, that's no problem.
Okay.
And I have a question, and is the money from the tree, is that money on hand? Or is that money, we're kind of shifting back and forth then other things we have to?
We paid for some trees out here, but we haven't took it out of the tree bank fund just yet. We will do that after we get our reimbursement, and Tom will take care of the bookwork as far as that goes.
Okay, but let's make sure there's a paper trail of money going in and coming back, going out.
I don't have to worry about Tom with paper trail.
Yeah, but he's got that. I mean, it's separate.
Okay, but that's good, but I just want the, and if you would, when it goes out and comes in, if we can have a copy for our minutes, that would be great. Thank you. Anything else on 5-2?
Well, do we want to go ahead and, I mean, is it too premature to come up with a date for May sometime for a sign? You know,
how long does it take?
If we don't have a deadline,
I know.
It's not going to happen.
How long would it take?
Get the sign made, do we think?
Couple of weeks, wouldn't it?
I would say so. I get with Signs and Wonders, and they usually get it out pretty quick for me.
And that's with the post and everything? I mean, of what?
Yes, ma'am.
Andrew was talking.
I'll give him the rendering, and he'll do it just like that.
Okay. Can you email us all a copy of the rendering just so we will remember exactly what it looks like, and we'll get the wording fixed and make sure we have the rendering and we know what everything's going to look like before we pay for it and get it put up?
Yes, ma'am.
If you want to send it to me, Wayne, I'll get it out to everyone.
Okay.
All right. So a date?
I'd say probably May is your safe bet, mid-May, but...
Thank goodness for phones. I have calendars. A Saturday? What did we decide? Or a Sunday afternoon? We talked about
Sunday afternoon.
Sunday afternoon is what we talked about.
21st?
Graduation there.
I mean the 22nd. I mean the 22nd. Well, is graduation on Sunday afternoon? I don't know.
No, it's not going to affect you. I was just trying to think.
School out the 18th, so graduation's that whole weekend, the 19th, 20th.
But people by Sunday. Yeah, I think 22nd's probably your...
Best date.
Because we don't
Mother's Day.
15th is the only other option. That might be a good one, Sunday the 15th.
Okay, well, do I hear a motion?
I'm out of town that week, but...
Oh, you are?
Well, let's do the 22nd. I'm not.
Yeah, let's do the 22nd. Do I hear a motion?
I make a motion that we have the dedication on May 22nd and for Dan Cubitt.
Time?
Second.
Time on it.
2:00. Is that a good time?
If it's hot, if it's gotten hot by then, 2:00 is going to be awfully hot.
Oh, please don't.
Hush.
Well, would you rather? I mean, you don't want to do it in the morning because it's Sunday, because it's church.
Maybe 3:00.
Yeah, if you think it'd
be cooler.
Yeah, in my mind it will.
Okay. Or 4:00.
Or how are you? Okay. So there's a motion on the floor, May 22nd, for the dedication.
Second.
I think we're still working out details. At 3:00?
At 3:00. There's a motion and a second. Discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Anyone opposed? May 22nd, 3:00. Wayne?
And we're going to meet here, correct?
Yes. Where are we going to meet here? We're going to meet in the Clover. We'll figure that out. Oh, this is April.
Well, at least we'll have another meeting, maybe, before this happens.
I think we better say there's going to be a lot of correspondence between then and there.
Okay, are we going to have it, where are we going to have it?
Well, I think we should do it in the location, but the biggest room is the one where people can stand around and probably less dangerous is the actual triangle section from 96. But how do we get there? I'm not really sure.
There's parking.
Could we have a shuttle? Could we talk to the school system about providing, letting us use a bus? Count Marymount has a bus, could we maybe?
Yeah, I mean, the churches might be the best way, I don't know. Boys and Girls Club, they like to use, donate there.
So.
That'd work.
So everybody park here and there'd be a shuttle? Wayne?
Shuttle mark now.
So, but everybody park here?
I'm also going to have police department have traffic control.
Okay.
So you're going to check on a shuttle, Wayne?
I'll see what I can find.
I mean, we could park at the bank and go, but that's a little bit too far down, right?
Might be able to, how about see if Food Saver lets use the front part of that where the bank is in that area?
Well, I'm talking Bank of America. Is it, how far down from Bank of America is it?
It's closer.
Closer?
Yeah.
But if you have any kind of.
Cox Road, right there in the corner of Cox Road.
About the ballpark where we do the food bank.
Yeah, I mean, either way, it's going to be a little bit of walk because it doesn't, it's just the period right and around 96 and 100. So I was just trying to see how far.
Well, if we have a shuttle, the shuttle can drop people off at the location, then shuttle, then circle back around and pick them up.
Would the church let us park there? I mean, we could just cross the street. The Church of Christ right there.
The thing about the church and the and Food Saver is Food Saver has customers still come in, and the church may have something going on that afternoon that we're not aware of. The bank should not on Sunday afternoon have any problem.
Where is the Food Saver? And we're like, what?
To the corner of Cox Road and 100.
Where H.G. Hills used to be.
Old H.G. Hills.
CB's.
No, you're asking why, yeah. I understand what you're saying. No, we're talking.
Parking.
Yeah, parking. But they could park at the bank, it's closed.
Or the ball fields.
Or the ball field. Either one.
The ball fields is a walk, right?
Yeah, you're walking up there.
And the bank is crossing the street.
Well, but if we have a shuttle to shuttle people from the ball field to the location, then it's easier for the shuttle to circle through the ball field, I would think. And you could either walk or ride the shuttle. Quando Place.
That's a good one, too. I bet they would let us park there.
So who's going to look into that? There you go. We have a volunteer, Wayne.
He's also doing the shuttle?
Yes.
I'll help you. I'll ask around.
Okay.
Okay. We good? 5-3, review and provide.
Mike had a good question.
About Dan.
Is Dan Kubik
able to
physically
come?
Able to come?
Anybody know?
I think I saw him in the grocery store not long ago, unless something.
I've seen him a couple of times this winter. Or this spring.
I'll contact the Kubiks.
Okay. If it rains, do we have a backup date? Or if Dan cannot come that date?
Should we have a tent? Can we afford a tent?
I'll donate my pop-up tent.
So I can get many people, but it'll get Dan.
Everybody else bring their own umbrellas.
Or a boat, whichever.
City has tents, too. If
yes,
we
ma'am. We need more than one.
We move on now, Jane.
Yes.
Thank you. 5-3, review and provide additional details and information on recommendations sent to the BOC from April 2015 commission meeting. Any update on the, I think that was the landscaping?
Yes, I think I've actually been responsible for putting that on hold because we didn't want to spend the money just right now. So I've told Mr. Craig that where we were at on that, so they'll be ready to present something once we have our money back in place.
Okay, thank you. 5-4, the fast-paced clinic update on unwrapping large tree out front.
Let's mark through it, because when I leave here, I'll go unwrap the large tree that's out front. I have to get in the back of my truck to do it, so.
Can we take video?
Yeah, I would love, y'all can join in.
We'll applaud.
Yeah.
So you're gonna actually go and unwrap it?
I have to get in the back of my truck and reach out into it, it's, you know, so. And I parked there, one day I was gonna do it, and people coming in and out of there, it was not good, so I have to do it in the evening.
Okay.
I'll do it tonight.
You mean, we'll hold the flashlights?
Yeah, I'll do it, please, I'll do it.
Okay, 5.5, the meeting place, the church on 96, update, Wayne and Mike on compliance issues and violation concerns.
A long story.
I'm ready for a quick answer, did we get it fixed?
It is fixed.
They have been to the planning commission with a new site plan, been approved. The night after the last, the morning after the last meeting, I was out there by 10 o'clock to see what was going on myself, and it was, did have water in it, but I put any stop work order on any site plans. I made sure that the orange fencing was around the big tree, and I also told them if there was any damage to trees that they would have to contribute to the tree bank fund. Asked them to not do any more heavy equipment under the other area. I give them 10 days to accomplish silt fencing and straw bales and stuff to hold back any overflow down behind the drainage behind Caspian Hills. Had a meeting with the contractor, the engineer, and the pastor, John Bledsoe and myself. This was after talking to our city attorney and our city engineer. And at that meeting, I told them if they needed to come on back with a new site plan and be approved by the city engineer, as well as being approved by the planning commission, which that did take place, and they got that done within the 10-day frame that I had given them to do so. What happens now that they've got a new site plan in, when they get ready for a certificate of occupancy, they have to present new as-built drawings. Will Owen will review those before we even give a CO to them. So they're well aware of that, and so hopefully everything will work out fine, and that's my update on that.
May I? So these photos were taken today, and I hope y'all can see, but this is...
Turn, please.
This is, as you're facing into the property, this is the left side. The right side has a construction fencing around one tree. They don't have it around all the trees that they're supposed to be protecting. And they dug that hole down in the middle of that forest.
Yeah, that hole is supposed to be filled back
so,
up, too.
So this, as you can see, this is not, you know, and...
I set it up here? That way everybody's going to sit it.
I want to show the reason that we have this in the first place. And
Can we get it up here?
Yeah, we just have to have this.
You have the USB?
Yeah, and tell me what it's labeled.
Oh, church.
Okay, that's good. Church on time.
Let me get this. It's high technology.
She's going to need it.
The minister says that one tree that's got the fencing around it, he's going to put a road through there. He's going to take that tree down.
So we're going to have to pay for the tree bank anyway.
Yeah, right. I don't think so. I don't think he will. And Mr. Hall, I This has been, since I've been visiting the site, the whole, by the retention, the basin being moved and everything, and I've got photos, as you're about to see, is that if we get a 2-inch rain, this flooded in the back, which has nothing to do with this board, but that whole thing is just a mess.
Well, that'll be left up to Will Owen, our city engineer.
But Wayne, has he?
The minister.
Yes, he's visited the site along with John Bledsoe. John does the inspection of the building. Will Owen will do the inspection of the as-built drawings once they finish the site development. They will get a CO until it's right.
I believe it's because it's a church.
One of the notes on the planning commission was from Will Owen in regards to drainage at that back area. He said that the adjustments made had a concern about proper drainage in that area. And Will said, as part of the bond, if that area does not perform, it'll be required to add a drain. And so it's in writing now to where I think we have a year on that bond to where if it was to wash out, that we also have a stipulation to add that drain, something similar to that.
But how much damage could it do? I mean, would it not, I mean, and I know nothing about engineering, nothing. Would it not make more sense to fix it now?
Well, you're still active construction right now, so you don't have your final grades. You don't have ground protection. So by the end, they would have either sod or they would have straw, seed and straw, and you would have things that would not, you'd slow your flow, your sheet flow would change, and hopefully you have better grades and swells, and I don't think they're there yet.
Shouldn't they already have the fencing up, though? The fence, the protection fencing at the drip line, shouldn't they already be up?
And in there, and there's some kind of, I mean, I think we've discussed this before, but so when you start building, when you get your directions from the tree board that this is what you, the tree commission, this is what you have to do, is there no checks and balances that before you start construction, that someone goes out and checks that construction site to make sure that you've done the requirements of
inspections. He doesn't do anything with site review.
Well, does anyone, I mean,
So if he sees anything wrong while he's out there, you know, he has to do periodic inspections. If he sees anything wrong that he thinks might need to be addressed, then we can pay the engineer to go out and see what we need to do, or I can do the same thing. I'm not an engineer either, so all I can do is impress on them what they need to do.
Well, I get, maybe you're not understand, maybe I'm not explaining my question well enough. It would seem to make sense to me that if you've gone through all the city processes and you have all your permits and you have everything in place, that there should be some sort of an ordinance or a rule or a something that before you can actually bring in bulldozers and start grading, that someone goes out and checks your work site to make sure that you've done everything that you've gone through the city processes to do. And if we just give everybody, okay, then this looks good on paper, you're good to go, but we don't check it to make sure they've done everything they said they were going to do, that we're losing a big loophole, and right here is the perfect example of what happens.
All I can do is check with Will and see if there's anything that that he suggests putting in place, but right now I know of nothing as far as site development goes.
Okay. Maybe that's something that the city, BOC would...
Well, it's probably something that we need to put into the planning commission workshop, and that's one thing I think probably needs to be done is a workshop with the tree board, the planning commission, the city engineer, and the city attorney.
Well, they have a checklist. Now, whether or not who's enforcing the checklist, and that's your question.
Right.
And that's actually, you know, a valid point, because if you have this checklist, you're given... Who's following up? We have John doing the building.
But no one makes sure that they've done all they're required to do before construction begins. Because if we'd had that in place, this would have been caught before it got to this point.
See, this. See, the soil is... Can you go back one? Go back one. Okay. See,
it's
the soil
up
is
the tree.
Up on the trunk of the tree. The tree is going to die.
Yeah.
Okay. So the idea, the reason we've had this in for years, is that you put the protection fencing, the tree protection fencing, out to the drip line. so that that cannot happen. Now, if they're taking that tree down, and then shouldn't that have come across this?
They're still, they have been told if there's any damage to the trees and they're going to die, that they got to contribute to the tree bank fund.
I think they believe you.
I don't think they believe you either. This has been strange from the beginning. You know, they never did come in with good plans. You know, they were to come back and do more stuff, and it was like they were never quite together. There was always loose ends. There was always kind of, we don't know what we're doing. We haven't decided yet. And so then the next thing I knew, they were building.
How many trees is the dirt next to you like that? A lot of them?
That's like this?
Yeah.
It's probably about half a dozen that,
half a dozen?
That are up on the root system like that.
And that's the road around the...
It's going around the back.
So the tree is right there where that, right there in the corner?
To the right. This, from the first slide to the end, it goes from the right facing into the property, 96 is to your back. You're going from right to left, swinging around 180 degrees. So the one tree, seeing this is...
Is that the same tree, or is that a different one?
No, I think that's the same. That's the same tree.
Okay.
The same roots have been hit with the bulldozer, so trees
have
gone down.
Was that tree on the tree inventory? Was that on their original plan? Was that tree to be taken out?
I don't remember.
We're going to hold them accountable for this. I think that's, maybe we should have had somebody inspect the site to see if the proper provisions, but that's even say they should know if they're a builder.
They've got the plans, the original plans, and it shows
protected,
original plans.
Non-protected, and they should be going around.
Around it.
The original.
There should be a fence up there.
The original plans with the tree worksheet, tree density worksheet, this tree here was in that safe zone that they were.
That's what I'm saying. If you got plans to show it, then you can say, okay, this is what's wrong. This is what you pay for. It's real simple.
Well, and I agree, but here's the thing. We can always go after the after, but we pretty much let them, build and do whatever they want and then say, pay a check, and that's not really what we want to do. I mean, we want to save the, in construction, the purpose of doing all that is to save the trees that they're not cutting down.
Well, my job description is to go out to the site and say, okay, this tree needs to be protected, whatever. And I've said that to one of the soups there long time ago. And they didn't really follow through with it, obviously, on that other side. So, but that's all I do is I hand them a card, city arborist, and say, this is supposed to have the tree protection. And the guy didn't even know anything about that. And I said, well, it's supposed to be out to the drip line. Don't put it up to the trunk. It's got to be out to the drip line.
So they ignored you. You told them
that's,
that.
That's all, and my job is.
And I've told them that, too. And
if you've told them, then why did we let them go ahead and do what they wanted to do? I mean, that's kind of like, that doesn't make much sense to me.
See, so this, you're talking a 10 feet out from this tree in the dead center, that's about an eight inch diameter there. You go about 10 feet to the right, that's where that fencing's supposed to be. And then, of course, the tree that has actually been hit and the roots been cut, you go to the edge of the slide, and that's about where the fencing is supposed to be on that. I don't remember this road being in the original design.
No.
It was added, wasn't it?
They've made some changes since we first saw this.
You said this is going down the left side?
This is going around
the
church.
I think it's on the last one, but not the first.
Then the last one.
I don't remember seeing that on the original. I didn't bring it to them.
No, not the first. We're saying it's in the second and plan that they brought. But it should have come the second plan back here.
Yes, mm-hmm. The tree commission should have, I mean, these trees. So let me make sure I understand what I'm hearing. So you've told them, Wayne's told them, and they still don't have the protection fence up. And that's today.
Yes, these photos were taken today.
Just to play devil's advocate from the other side of the coin. Like the plans that we had was like a tree list. This is a tree list, like an inventory list. I don't think there was ever, like that plan that I saw didn't really have a buffer area. Like I wish that we would have had an upfront layout of this is what you have to follow, because then you can hold them to it much more. But it's so vague that it's so hard to go out there and tell them. What's sad is that we've come to, like, we're trying to manage their project almost to where these are state licensed contractors that should have to follow. I don't know if you call TDEC and ask them to come look at it. They're probably in violation of erosion control, you know, and try and get some help. But I think what do we learn from it to prevent it happening again? And what can we do to help make it better? Look at the site, and then we count trees to get, you know, the fees at the ends. If it was in a protected area and we're missing trees, we do another inventory list, and, you know, we're 50 trees out, and then make sure that their stormwater control matches the stormwater plan that they submitted.
What do you mean it was vague?
Just that the sheet that I saw that one time Mr. Berkeley had was just kind of an inventory sheet. It didn't really have a tree plan. Like, you need to have a buffer zone here. You need to have like two layers of buffer.
Well, we discussed, because they fought us about putting up the buffers, because it says in the ordinance that if you're within so many feet of residential plot that you have to put up so much. What was the buffer zone? And you had to, and they fought us on that because it was going to cost them some.
Well, I brought up the buffer zone too. I wasn't on the tree board when this came forward. I think I joined right after. But I brought up the buffer zone because I remember you guys discussing how you required a buffer on the backside, and I asked them about it, and they said yes, that they would be planning on adding it. So I think that would be something that we'll look on the back end too, to make sure that they submit to the requirements that you guys put to them. It's a shame that they're working the system.
You guys get that at the planning commission too.
Yes, sir. Yep, we discussed those trees.
The same.
Yes, sir.
Basically, this should be a recommendation from here and go to the other board, the planning commission, so that we'll know for sure what the buffer zones and stuff are.
I say you do a stop of work order until the guy can come in here and get the proper fence in.
I think that was what we decided at the last meeting.
In the planning commission meeting, the preacher stepped up. I said, our city arborist went out there. He said, you have a clear open hole and you remove some trees. To where that hole is. And the preacher stepped up and said, we didn't remove any trees for that hole. So it's hard not to take preacher's words. You know, I don't know.
Well, where's the inventory list?
Well, yeah, I mean, did the planning commission not have the inventory list?
I don't know.
What did y'all look at when y'all took the minister's word for that?
I didn't have an active inventory list, no, ma'am.
I think the last meeting we discussed the stop work order. We just let the, I mean, here they still don't have the stuff, and we're still letting them work. I don't understand.
I think you just.
Patty, is there no process?
If I was this contractor, and I hope that the site wouldn't look like this if it was mine, but.
We'd stop work on yours too.
Yeah, but I'm saying if you brought me that inventory list and told me that it was a tree protection plan, it'd be hard to hold my hand to it. I just wish that was more spelled out of what we were asking of them. And it's sad that they're blatantly just disregarding everything that.
And they are blatantly. They've ignored Mike. They've ignored Wayne. They still aren't doing what they're supposed to be doing. And the city is still allowing them to go on ahead and build. So I don't understand why we even have an ordinance. If it's okay, this is what you've agreed to do for us to let you build in the city. But then you start building, you don't do any of it, and we're saying, well, okay, well, you just go ahead, and when you finish, we'll see how much damage you've done, and we'll charge you.
And should our damage after the fact be more damage
than what it was before the fact?
I think so.
I do too, but.
Because if you're saying we're taking out these trees, we're not going to replace them, so we're going to contribute to the tree bank,
and then
they go along and they go ahead and take out a half a dozen more pretty good sized trees, because they just thought they could if they wanted to.
Patty,
how do you stop it?
What's the answer? You're the mayor. What's the answer?
You're the mayor.
Yeah. Let's see what that gets you.
Let me make this suggestion.
Yeah.
I got two meetings downtown tomorrow, but I'll check it out again tomorrow afternoon. And I want to go back and review what Will and the attorney said with them, and if they haven't complied with what we asked for it before, then I'm going to put a stop work order on it.
I think we got to. I mean, here's the thing is, you know, they can come in and get, I mean, this is, protecting the trees is simple. I mean, what's that damage is done, I mean, we're going to, you know, have to charge them for whatever, but we, to sit there and let them keep working, especially when they're saying, they're disputing what you're saying, that there was a tree there, I mean, really can't trust what they're...
The logs were laying there, and it, you know, where they came. And this, I'm looking back on, kind of, I feel like Jane Woodall, back in the minutes, let's see, July of 2015, Tuesday of 07, okay, and Meeting Place Assembly of God Church revised landscape plans, and John Goff, that was the supposedly the landscape architect representing the church. Let's see, Jane had a question about the tree density worksheet, and this was discussed. Additionally, the number and type of trees, deciduous versus evergreen, used for screening was discussed at length. Nothing's happened about that, of course. A motion was made, seconded, and passed by the Tree Commission to approve the revised plans contingent on the following. One, adjusting the planting on the buffering zones with the tree type from the official tree list. Two, adjusting the tree density of the buffering zones to be compliant with the Fairview Design Review Manual. Section inclusion of a permanent irrigation system. And I'm going to tell you, they are not going to put an irrigation system in. They would have already had it stubbed out. So, and four, revision and correction of the tree density worksheet revised to correct the trees being removed, specifically the one 22-inch oak, and that's that one that
was
on the first.
Is that that one right there?
No, that's the other one that...
stands out further
than
coming in.
Right, on the right side as you're facing in. It was listed incorrectly and taken in consideration the additional plantings noted on items 1 and 2 in this motion. And then the last is review and approval by the city arborist. And I never got that.
Well, I have a question. So would this not have been enough information for the Planning Commission to hold their feet to the fire about what was required of them? I mean, this sounds very detailed.
That's all additional buffering. That's all it added.
Added.
What do you mean added?
You're saying adding buffering.
Well, this is something they were supposed to take care of right up front.
This was their original appearance here.
This is required for what they...
To add buffering on the backside and things? Is that what you just read?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So it would be added. Like, that wouldn't be... They're not done.
They're...
Adding the buffering was just one part of all the expectations.
This is all of this. I'm supposed to see a plan
with it on there
and check it off. And the way I would do it is that the codes director calls me and said, okay, I've got the new plan. And I would swing by the office and I would look it over and sign off. I haven't gotten anything. I haven't seen anything.
And so
maybe there is one that nobody's called me yet, but I haven't seen.
I don't think on this there was any trees issued. I mean, talked about, I think it was to revise the site plan.
And so the Planning Commission should have had the revised site plan with the buffering drawn. You should have had that.
Pretty sure, and this is a long time ago, but I'm pretty sure there was some buffering drawn, and our approval was contingent on the additional buffering, I think on the back row that you guys had enforced. And so when that would happen, we approve it contingent on this, and the site plan will be adjusted and final approved inside the city with the new revised drawing.
So you've seen a plan that shows the buffering, the trees?
I can't say for sure. I'm pretty sure they had some on like the right side maybe, and then you guys had requested on the back. We discussed it and said we approve it contingent on the back buffering. I'll have to read the notes and check the plans.
Yeah, because I haven't seen that. And well, would you know what those trees are?
Were you in staff review when they come through for the Planning Commission?
That was before I think Mike even started going to.
I think that was way back.
So, okay, so.
Brown, a couple of months ago, were I?
Yeah, you wasn't in staff review a couple of months ago when they come through?
Was the new buffering drawn on there? So, okay, so I understand the process.
Maybe that's a meeting I missed or something, but no, I don't remember it.
When I go home tonight, I'll try and find that packet, and I will try and get that revised, or see if it is a revised, or see if it's the one.
I mean, I would like to see it. I mean, even the, and I'm guessing that these trees that are listed in the buffer, you know, that they are off of the approved tree list, but I'd like to see what they are.
Yep.
So now I'm really confused about a while ago when you said that if you'd had something, we can't hold their feet to the requirement if we don't have it written, or we don't have it. So shouldn't the planning commission, if you required more and a revised plan?
Buffering, I was speaking on the tree protection, like the orange fencing around trees and things like that is what I was.
Well, I think that's part of the, and that part of the requirements, I mean, that.
Everything on this tree protection ordinance, tree planting protection in it says is authorized by the codes department. So all of these enforcements are codes department. It wouldn't be the planning commission, it wouldn't be the city arborist, it would be the codes department.
Right, but I got lost while ago when you were saying that you didn't have enough information to, the planning commission didn't have enough information to.
I didn't say the planning commission. I said, me in particular, that when I saw that, that was an inventory list. That wasn't a, this is where you put protected trees.
Did you not see the plan where they had the trees?
I'm not.
They actually had a plan where.
The inventory tree list.
You talk about the first plan?
Right, because that's the reason we said this tree is not.
That would be the only one that's been submitted right now.
Yeah, so there's not been a revised plan.
I don't know that came into the planning commission when we did that.
No, we wouldn't see an inventory list. That would all be the site engineer and things like that.
It was more than just an inventory list.
Yeah, he gave us the whole, well, he's.
And we would never see any of that stuff, because that would be following the ordinances across.
Well, maybe that's something we should provide.
Well, originally it was set up that building plans came here first. If we approved their landscape plan, then it went on to the planning commission. Somehow, that's become very convoluted, and so that's not happening. But that was when we had all those workshops, and we stayed here night after night, hour after hour. That was what was decided, that all those plans would come here to the tree commission first. We would sign off on it and send it to the planning commission. So the planning commission knew that we had approved their landscape plan. We had approved the trees they were planting. They had required buffering. Everything was in place from this end, so that the planning commission didn't have to worry about that. Well, now all of a sudden, it seems to be going back and forth to the same commission and the same committee, and we're still not getting revised plans, and we're still getting this.
Just a reminder, I don't work for the city. I'm a planning commissioner. I'm one meeting a month. I have tried to dig into that, and that'll be a discussion we have with the suburb or the development stuff, subdivision development stuff, when we get to that on the agenda. But I think that with the change of the guards, I think Mr. Owen has been pushing very much on the front end things, on the site plans and things, and he's kind of following the ordinances. And he wasn't present, I wasn't present, he doesn't know the interpretation of what the intention was. But I think there's no ordinance stating that the tree committee sees those things. And that's what he came back to me with when we dug into the ordinances thing. We'll talk about that.
Well, I think Debbie's 100% correct. This is why the system was put in place, and this is why it should be followed in the original way that it was extended, because somebody would have caught this. But what's happened, exactly what you could have predicted would have happened, is something like this got missed because of the simple not having, you know, are we going to expect the planning commission to do both jobs, or, you know, so I really, you know, think that's something that needs to be addressed.
No, absolutely. But I think inventory lists and things like that are all things that are in that staff review meeting. I don't think we would ever get an inventory list for the planning commission's up there counting the number of trees on the site or anything like that.
Well, no, that's what we do. But we also have a landscape plan. It's not just an inventory. We also have their landscape plan.
Yeah, I haven't seen those documents for this place. I wasn't on this board when they came through. I saw it when Mr. Berkeley brought it that one time to the meeting.
And you can tell by the minutes of the things they had to do, but they never came back here with anything. And the next thing we know, they're building. So someone had to approve it. Who approved it? Or did they just start building?
Well, Well, and it would be something, if Mr. Berkeley was at the meeting, he could have called. I mean, I don't know what meeting, you know, but.
And it may be that one that I had to miss one back in the fall, I guess.
I mean, I can still remember how shocked I was when we had so many questions about their landscape plan and what they were doing and the buffering, and they didn't want to do that. They didn't want to spend the money. And they were supposed to come back to us, and Mike was supposed to let us know if he'd approved what he was going to look at. And I was driving by one day, and they'd started building. So there's a massive breakdown.
They came back to this board twice, didn't they, Mike?
No. Did they come back twice?
Yes, they did.
Get the reason why I have to look back, but they were here twice.
And it was approved by this board.
So we have something to hold them liable, though.
We had the contingent.
It was approved only with the contingency.
Right. We approved that, but it was
If, if they did.
We approved it. You know, when we approve something here, goes across this board, we approve it and it hasn't started yet. Are we the ones that are enforcing that, I think? And so, you know, we say, okay, make sure you put the construction fencing around or the protection fencing around. It's got to be out to the drip line. Don't put soil on top of the roots of these trees.
Roots of the trees and don't run heavy equipment over it, you know.
We, you know, and I think that's, you know, where I'm confused is that what is the role here? We're obviously concerned about it. And my biggest concern is like the damage is done. Some trees are going to be gone.
Yeah.
But every time we say, well, this is not going to happen anymore, and it's happened again.
Well,
you know, since we've
happened that before.
Every time we say that it's not going to happen, well, I can tell you with what we did with.
Are you going to say Bowie Commons?
Yeah. Bowie Commons was one that, you know. So I will do what my supervisor asked me to do. And I will enforce, but I'm not supposed to go out there and say, okay, if you don't do this, I'm going to do this.
Well, I wish that you would call me when you see the thing so I can go with you.
Yeah.
Then I can have a little more input into it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know,
but I think that.
Rather than wait to this board.
Well, I think that this is because this happened. I had to get these photos like real. I was out of town today, and I had to get these photos real quick and.
Here I have a question. So according to these minutes, they were supposed to let Mike approve. They were supposed to revise their plan, and it was approved contingent on Mike seeing the revised plan and approving it. Did that ever happen? Did you ever see a revised plan?
And maybe that was the staff review meeting that I missed.
But still, if it was supposed to be approved by Mike before they could start, whether he missed the meeting or whatever, that trail should have still happened.
It should be a follow-up between Mike and myself. In other words, if something's going on, that's right.
Like John Bledsoe doing his inspection.
Yes, if we're relying on Mike to do an inspection, which I'll have to find out how this has been in the past. All
when
I can
did
do
the
is
revised plan come through?
Don't know.
I don't remember, but I do know they were here twice.
That was a long time ago.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was for the tree board.
Yes.
A long time ago. Yeah, but they were on the planning commission a couple
of times also,
ago.
I think.
Yeah. They came once, and then they came back with the meeting you were
revised plan.
To.
Yeah. The revised site plan.
But it had to do with that road and.
Right.
Something
and the
else.
Detention
the
pond.
Plans didn't affect anything that we would need to see.
The revised plan moved the detention pond.
The detention pond primarily was what was being focused on.
Well, and Wayne, you said that Mike should call you if when he sees stuff like this. When was our last meeting?
January.
So in January, Mike brought it to this board's attention that this was going on.
That's where I was out there at 10 o'clock the next morning.
Right.
And he got the process started to get it corrected, but apparently they haven't corrected it properly.
This is April. So January, February, March, April. So
yeah, but they've gone through the planning commission with a new site plan and everything. So
well, so when they had their new site plan, did the planning commission check the work site to see what was being done or not done?
I don't know whether they did a site review or not. But that was always my suggestion to go do a when they got a new plan before them to go look at the site.
Well, surely if somebody on the planning commission had looked at this and realized...
The revised site plan was a detention pond with drainage, so our city engineer went out and reviewed it. Me, walking out there, I'm not an engineer, I couldn't go tell you, I went and looked at it, but the site plan was for the pond, the detention pond.
Well, I'm not an engineer, nor am I a builder, and I can look at that and tell it's wrong.
Yeah, but that particular motion and approval was based on the site, the location of the detention pond.
Great, Scott, so you mean we can't see anything else if you go out?
The planning commission is not responsible for the building and codes, and it's, that's the city, the city officials.
As a builder, do you have any suggestions of what could be done in the process between what all you've seen done so far, as far as you sit on the planning commission?
One thing we've had massive...
You gotta get him in there.
One thing we've had massive discussions on is the terminology and our codes and things. It is a mess in our processes, and I think that we can start cleaning up once we have someone sitting in the planning codes director position focused on only that. But the next discussion we have is like the only document that touches anything on tree inventory, replacement requirements, tree bank is the design review manual. And the design review manual does not reference the tree board anywhere of enforcing that. And so technically the only thing...
No, we don't enforce
anything. We just make a recommendation.
But I'm saying that's...
It doesn't.
That's what I'm saying is we are not in charge of telling them what they would have based on the design review manual, because it doesn't make mention of the tree board.
You say we...
In the planning commission.
Tree board.
I mean, do you mean the planning commission doesn't...
It doesn't what?
Doesn't have any say-so and what's...
When we would get our minutes, they would tell us if it meets the design review manual. So the engineer would go through, the staff review meeting would go through all of our ordinances, our design review manual, and they would make a list of anything that we were missing outside of that.
So if we had something with the tree in the design review and they coincided, then he's saying, then you have the leg, you know, to catch it. Yeah.
The planning commission is not in charge of the building. We're approving zonings, and then we're making sure it matches our ordinances.
I understand that.
Site inspections? That's not our job.
I understand. Right? Well, it's not our job. But to me, it's kind of like if we drive down the road and we see somebody robbing a bank, it's not our job to enforce it, but we tell someone. If you go out there and look at this and you know it's wrong, why don't you come back and say?
What authority do I have to do anything? When we had the meeting, the planning commission meeting, I asked about the buffering, I asked them about what the city arborist had brought up at our meeting, and they assured us they didn't knock down trees, they moved the detention. I mean, that's, a preacher stands up and talks to me, I don't have the
So if I stand up and tell you, I'm okay.
Right here, that prior to any site work, the developer contractor must erect a temporary barricade of orange net fencing, having a minimum, blah, blah, blah. And all this, no clearing, grading, or tree removal prior to plan approval. So before they can do any of that, we have to approve the plan, and it also has to be approved by the planning commission. And they're not even supposed to start any work till all those barricades are up.
There's a process with the codes guy does his inspection. There's got to be the landscaping and all the protection put in and all that. Has to either be in that inspection, or Mike's got to do the inspection, or something.
Yes, sir.
How was they even able to start work if the fencing was not already up?
That was my question.
That's in our ordinance.
So why are we not, who's enforcing that, Wayne? Whose job is it to enforce to make sure the orange fencing's up?
I just want to make a suggestion to try to solve this. The planning commission meets on the second Tuesday of each month. They already have a workshop scheduled for this next meeting. In May, would y'all have an objection of having a joint workshop with them present, the planning commission, the tree board, and then the city engineer be here, and also the city attorney. And let's get this hashed out to where I know what needs to be done the proper way.
I'm willing to hash out anything, but I want this answered. Jane's question. Let's go back to Jane's question.
Well, this can only be answered in that workshop so that I'll have...
Fairview Codes Department.
Right.
It also says...
Which we didn't have.
A tree protection plan would be required by a certified arborist, licensed surveyor, landscape architect, or an engineer. Do we have a actual tree protection plan or just the inventory list? And that's what I was saying is, do we have something that we say, here is where your protection should be?
Isn't that what this says?
That's what this is.
This is right.
That's what Jane ran.
A plan for them before they start construction. It says, a plan to be created by a surveyor, certified arborist, and landscape architect or engineer.
That's what they brought to us, was a plan.
When I saw it, it was an inventory list. That's what I'm saying. If we had a plan...
We had the plan.
Okay, let's bring it, is what I'm saying.
What he's saying, we...
If we have a plan, we can go hold them to it. And say, here's what you're supposed to be following.
Planning commission.
And that's what he's saying. I mean, this is not gonna solve any problems. We understand there's a breakdown, but it's time to figure out, okay, yes, this is what went wrong, and how can we fix it? If we wanna go pull the plan out, let's go get it. I'm sure, do you have it back there?
So you're saying the engineer came to us with this plan.
The landscape architect.
Went through that plan, and then it went to the planning commission, but it didn't go to you? He just walked in there and talked?
Well, they didn't give us the...
Are you speaking of? Well, I don't see the inventory tree list.
Oh, I thought you said that's all you had.
Mr. Berthley brought that here to a meeting. I feel like you guys are twisting...
Tree approvals was back when Frank was here.
No, we were here.
I have become the bad guy in their mess.
They came to the tree board back when Frank was here.
If we have a tree protection plan, though, that says this is a plan that we signed, they had to provide, then we can say, we can lay that out on their site and say, you are not following any of this. And then we really have something to hold them to the burner. If we have that plan, is what I'm saying. I wish that we had that follow-through.
Okay, that's, so why don't you get it?
I'm not in charge of creating that.
No, I was gonna say, why was it not brought to you? Why was it not brought? Do we know why it wasn't brought to the planning commission with...
If it went to the tree, it would be on the tree board to sit on it.
I think it's like what you're saying. Most members used to assume that everything's approved by your tree. We didn't get all the, you know, ands and buts, and you're supposedly at the resign review, so, you know, and anybody can take a day off, and we all get a day off. It's still, when he doesn't show up, then all of a sudden, then the codes department or city manager, whoever, needs to say, this is what you missed, and can we review? There was a step missed, and the step got missed, because obviously...
One of our contingencies...
It's not working.
One of the contingencies of the approval of the planning commission would be contingent on the approval of the tree board's buffering and notes.
So if you never saw the plan, then planning commission never should have signed anything, correct? And I'm not coming down on you, Brandon.
But not the tree, we would never see a tree inventory plan. We saw a site plan. We saw a stormwater plan. We saw construction plans.
It did not have a landscape plan attached to it. I
don't recall it having one.
And why would it have been signed off if that's part of the requirement?
It's contingent on that approval. And so if you have to sign off on it, then the staff is responsible for getting all the final work to come in and say, yep, it was contingent on this. We got this. Now we can go.
That would have probably gone to the city engineer to get approval from the city. And it looks to me like there's a possibility that our checklist is not set up as such to be able to go from point A to point C because B is being missed. So that's probably what has to be done in this planning, is to get all the ducks in a row so that it goes from A, B, C, D.
And that's good that you see that, Brandon.
No, I think the biggest thing is closing this. We need to close this gap. We need to have a better structure.
It's good that you're seeing what you didn't see.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? And so maybe when we have this meeting, and you've got this man here talking about it, and we decide this plan, you take it with you.
And that's good, because with him being at the tree board level, right, he'll be looking for that at the planning commission level.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Should be a sign. You should have something saying the tree board loves this.
And as a sitting on the tree board, I'm trying to be an advocate for the tree board, and that's why I brought what Mr. Berthley brought up, and I brought up some of those points to the church. I'm trying to make sure that what is discussed here is transferred over to try and make a voice. That's why I'm sitting
here.
That's
why we're saying we saw what we did and what was here. And we don't know what you saw.
And I can't verbatim see what the minutes were that night. I will definitely read them tonight, though, and try and find that site plan of what they brought across to us.
So it boils down to, now what are we going to do?
Yeah, that's.
So let's, are we going to try to get this, I mean, they're still not doing what they were supposed to have done in January.
Just what I suggested a minute ago.
I would love to meet with you, and maybe even Will, there at the site sometime, and on your schedule. I'll be glad to do it. And you know, this is my craziest time of the year.
Yeah.
I'll be glad to do it.
It's also very expensive for me to bring Will here, too, so.
Oh, well, then, okay.
Well, Will's already there for something else.
But I try to schedule stuff like that on the day of the planning commission, so that I won't have to pay.
You let me know. I'll be glad to meet.
And it's been a budget process, too, because of that. You know, it's one of our highest-paid vendors is our city engineer, as the mayor well knows, so.
Then maybe just you and I.
I think it'd be good for you and Will to have a session, too.
I would like to just, and I think that also, if those guys see you and I there, and we're, you know, that maybe this will carry a little weight as well, so. But I can paint, I have a paint gun that I paint out lines with to show them where the, I mean, I'll do that, you know. But the damage is done. I am shifting now to more into prevention than trying to cure this.
Yeah.
Is I would love to keep this from happening again.
Okay, is it possible that when you go, that you take the landscape design that we saw with you when you go out there and lay it out and say, this is what you brought to us, this is what we approve with these revisions, show us where you're doing this?
I'll see if I can find the last approval where he hadn't inspected it yet.
That he says he's not seen.
Yeah.
But you know, Wayne, here's what, and I'm going to go way back to Don LaVorn, is that this communication line, he would call me up and says, okay, I just got the revised plan. It's sitting here in the office. And I would drive right over here, go or over at the other building, and walk in and look at it and take 10, 15 minutes and sign off. It worked. I'd be glad to do that.
I thought that the thing that I'd suggested you being in the staff review was working real good,
and
too.
And I've gotten a lot. I think there's been some great things that's come out of it. I really appreciate being on the staff review, and especially with a lot of the subdivisions, you know, development coming in. But this has been great, and I'm learning a lot from Will. He's amazing.
Yeah.
But that, you know, sometimes those plans, I mean, it's just a matter of, you know, the staff review is great. I thought that the staff review meetings was to prevent, like a new guy comes in, a new developer comes in, is prevent any mistakes. Okay, here's what the city requires. Then after that goes through all the boards and everything, and there's a revision, the codes director calls me up and says, okay, they just submitted to my office. Here's the revision. You want to come by and take a look at it? I'd love to do it. And that's the kind of communication I would like to do. And then also, when I see things like this happen, I'd like to be able to tell the codes department. Out in front of the warehouse storage place down on Highway 100 on the other side, we required 4-inch caliber red buds along that. One's dead and one's dying.
And not on the agenda.
But I'm just, my point is, that's the kind of thing that I would like to be able to, so that we can, and then, I don't know if that's the tree commission, or if that's between codes.
I think it's going to be left up to me in the future.
Well, and I think, too, before, when Don was here, and Mike would come out and look at those revisions and approve them, Don would always send out, Mike has been here and approved this, and we knew it had been approved, and we all knew. And now it's kind of like, we have these things that you can be approved if Mike, you know, signs off on this, and here we are.
Well, that's what I thought the process was with him coming to the staff review, that he was given his approval in staff review.
But are the revisions at the staff review?
Yeah, there's not. That's where I'm confused on the staff review is to say, okay, you have to do this, this, and this.
Yeah. But I've actually seen you say that this plan looks good.
Yeah.
Right in the staff review.
Yeah. And so that means there's not much more I have to.
Right.
You know.
But then that plan.
I thought that process was working. this process, I don't have any idea on because I wasn't involved.
But if they come back, if I say, okay, just make sure you got this, get it off the approved tree list, and they say, sure. And if I don't see that again, whatever they put on there, if I don't see that again, I don't approve that, then it's out of my control. I just want to be in that follow-up, I guess.
Oh, in the staff review, you're not really approving it even though you like the plan.
I don't think he has the authority to approve in a staff review.
He's got to sign off on it.
All I'm telling, I thought the idea of the staff review meeting is to prevent, to save some steps. That instead of this plan coming to the tree commission, oh yeah, you can't do this, is to prevent that from happening, right? Is to say, okay, if you're going to have this commercial property, you've got to have these trees, you know, and I've said that in the staff review meeting.
So you give guidance and pre-approval before it comes to the tree.
Pre-advice.
So when it comes to this.
Forward.
It's okay, there's no surprises.
Yeah.
Especially for the developer. Is that, okay, I know this is what I had to do. Because the city arborist has already said, well, you need to do this, you need to do this. You can't, no, that's not a tree you can use because that's not on the approved tree list. So that by the time it gets here, he's not going to come back another month because he didn't come to this board with the right.
If there's something that Mike has missed in that review and it comes here and we catch it, then it's okay, we will approve this contingent on your revision of this. But if Mike has never seen the revision, then there's the failure. And so then when it goes to the planning commission, if Mike has not signed off, if the tree commission has not signed off, and then they see this was required and Mike has not signed off on the revision requirements, then it's not happening.
Do you have the times that they came, Jane, on this particular?
I have to go back and look at the minutes.
Okay.
So, okay, do we need to make a recommendation? Do we need to send a recommendation to somewhere, someone about this now? Patty?
I don't think I have all the past minutes.
No, I mean, Mr. Hall said he would put a stop order, work order on it, and so we'll do that. Have you meet back over, tell the guy again when y'all go out there. Have the guy come out there.
And I'm going to have Will look at it next week when he comes.
Well, maybe, or y'all could do it when Will's there and I'll do it together.
Has Will been out there already?
Yes. Yes, he was out there in January, remember, and told them what they needed to do.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And they resubmitted a site plan, which went to the planning commission board. And like Brandon said, it was addressed more of the detention pond than anything else.
And John Bledsoe has been back out?
John doesn't have anything to do with the site plan.
He's building.
It's just the
building.
Building.
And that's what I think.
And
probably
see, that's
needs
where I
to,
think we're lacking is, yeah, we don't have a site plan inspector.
And that's probably what we need, yeah, to look at, so, if that's a piece, and you know that is.
And like I was saying, Brandon, from your knowledge of the developments and stuff, how do they go about doing that? Most of them do they have.
Every municipality has different ways. There's some municipalities that won't give you your building permit until you have your steel fence, erosion control, and you know, construction entrance in place.
Who kind of comes by and checks on that?
A building inspector would confirm it.
The code guy?
Yes, sir.
So, there you go.
That's just an added, maybe.
We're just so restricted to the staff. I know it's hard. And those municipalities need 20 inspectors, you know.
Well, and it may be something that when, you know, we have all our focus back in the codes,
right,
then, you know, that would be something easily, you know, could be done by the codes director.
And I think it's also important that we hear.
I could actually be taught to go out and make sure, with Mike's help, that the silt fencing was down and the screening was down. You know, that's.
I think it's also very important that we hear from the developer that other cities require that.
Right.
So there's not going to be that business of, well, you know, no one else requires that. Why is Fairview requiring it? Other cities do require it. And I think that we have to get past this point of thinking that no one's going to build here if we require them to do something. This is the last place in Williamson County where there's barely property to build on. So if we don't think that people are going to come here and build, even if we require them to put up an orange fence, then we're not thinking.
I agree.
We got to get sewer first.
Oh, yeah, but the point is, they're going to come here and build. no matter, I mean, other cities require this. So we need to be as good as other cities.
Well, and Thompson Station has the same water issues that we do, and they, I guarantee you, are protecting their trees and requiring...
A lot more stringent things.
Small, much traffic goes through Thompson Station right now, going through it.
And they also require that, we have to stop thinking that no one wants to come here, and we have to bend over backwards and give them the farm to get them to come here and build.
I don't think that's...
I don't think we're doing that part, so, at least I...
Okay.
I think if you can tell Mr. Berkeley when Will comes to the planning commission, I think it'd be great to have that discussion with Will. He's the one, I think it's really been heading up the ordinances, and that's who I reached out to about what ordinances have been approved with the tree and stuff. He's really well versed on it, and I think he can help. He's trying his best. When he approves it, Will's time, if Will doesn't spend the allotted amount of hours on planning commission meeting, Will's working on cleaning up our ordinances and our programs like this to try and better it. And we've made some strides, but we still have a long way to go.
Sure.
Okay, so Wayne, you'll let us know. You'll update us on the progress.
And Wayne, if you get any kind of notes and want it sent out, if you would just email me, and I can pass it in between meetings if we need to get some conversation going.
Okay, 5-6, National Arbor Day plans. All right, and that what we decided we'd do for the dedication?
Yes.
Okay.
But that's now going to be pushed off into May. But didn't you say, didn't we say the planting for the...
Yeah, the actual planting would be the Arbor Day stuff.
Will it be by the end of April if it gets done?
Oh, I don't know.
Didn't you say
sure, we plant something? Didn't you?
They said it would have the planting done by the end of the month. Is what they told me this morning.
And poof, there we are.
They're the professionals, and we get a year's warranty on it.
They'll have a bunch. And what did they talk about with TDOT about the traffic control? Are they shutting down a lane?
Not on the agenda. We'll be here all night.
That's part of the treescape. We just
it
already passed
the,
it.
Yeah, it's part of the roadscape. Okay.
If they finish the planting, maybe we can get some, or if that looks like they're well into the planting process, maybe we get just some recognition in the paper. Observer, just to note that that's part of...
Our Arbor Day.
We'll also put it on the website also.
Start planning now for next year's open.
What's your point? Okay. Anything else on that? New business, 6.1, Tree Commission's role on suburb. I don't know what I thought that word was, development.
Suburb.
Did I spell it incorrectly?
Maybe that's why I thought.
I don't know, did I?
So, it's something that when we were going back through the review of the...
Ordinance,
yeah, thanks. And it came to the duties of the tree commission, and I remember that evening that Jane actually said it. To review all tree protection plan proposals relating to subdivision development and site development plans for submission to the planning commission for review. So is that, and Brendan, you said something via email. Wow, months ago, that
wasn't there.
Well, it says all other tree commission recommendations shall pass directly to the board of commissioners for approval. But so I'm confused. So, and my point on this is that if we are, as this commission, is to protect the urban forest, and the largest clear cutting of the urban forest is from the subdivisions. Now, some of these guys, through the staff review meetings, some of these guys that volunteered and said, look, we'll do this, the street trees will be this, whatever, but most of these subdivisions are coming in and they're taking all the trees out. And there's no, and maybe I'm wrong, but I don't see anything that they have to replace anything. And then on the monuments out front, should they not like a commercial application, follow the approved tree and shrub list? So.
I think that was the original intention, and, you know, that used to come through here.
And I'm just bringing this up because it's in here, and it's very.
Monument, you talked about the monument sign?
Yeah, out front, the entrance to the.
To a subdivision.
Should they not?
Oh, I got you.
I listened to the guys in staff review meeting call them monuments, and that's what I.
In that reference that I made, it was, I apologize, in reference to the designer review manual and then the community tree plan, but the only document that we have an ordinance on currently that touches tree inventory, replacement requirements, or tree bank is the designer review manual. And then the designer review manual only applies to commercial, industrial, and multifamily developments. And so that's where I think residential subdivisions are getting left out.
So this needs to be rewritten so that that's taken out.
Wait a minute, it only applied, read that, Brandon, read that, I'm sorry, it only applies to what?
The designer review manual only applies to commercial, industrial, or multifamily apartments, developments.
Multifamily apartments or developments?
Right.
Which is why the apartment complex over on 96 is.
So how do we get this that we always assumed was part of the rule of the land? How do we get this back into the rule of the land?
The one thing that our tree planting protection speaks to is a community tree plan, is that the tree board would create a community tree plan, has the authority to formulate a community tree plan. Once formulated, the community tree plan is to be approved by the BOC. There's no formal record of a community tree plan being formulated by the tree commission nor adopted by the BOC. And so almost in essence of the tree board going enforcing the tree things from the design review manual was kind of out of procedure. And so we need to find a way to either, and if you guys, you, I know you mentioned y'all spent a lot of time on the design review manual, and somehow it got cut out to the tree board enforcing or being a part of those processes. So we need to somehow create a proposal or a document that brings us back in that loop to officially do it.
Well, how did it ever get, how was there a proposal passed?
It was being done incorrectly, I think, previously. And I think that's where we've lost it is now, where Will's going through these steps, he's following in the ordinances that he has approved, so he's following the language and the paper in front of him instead of what was known to the last guy prior. And so now he's gone through the ordinances and sees that the only thing that restricts trees is the design review manual, and then the design review manual does not speak to the tree board enforcing. And so I don't think it's in any, you know, disregard of the tree board. I don't think he's trying to cut anybody out, but his paperwork is, that's what it says.
Patty, how do we fix that?
Well, and that's part of what he's trying to do. I mean, basically, when we even got up here and was talking about the Planning Commission, some of the things that we were doing on the Planning Commissions were not really laid out in this. And so here we thought we were approving, you know, minor changes that we could do, and come to find out really how it was worded was only the Board of Commissioners. So actually everybody got upward thinking they were trying to take something away, but actually we were trying to keep the Planning Commission doing exactly. So by sounds like we just need to add verbiage into from this, you know, into the design review, and it would be a simple, you know, fixed. But that's where
but then in
regards,
and then in regards to subdivisions too, I think it's so hard to enforce any kind of tree protection inside those individual lots. And a lot of times you'll have a development where your outside area will be a protected green space to where you would never knock those down. But an individual lot, you couldn't ever require.
And we didn't. That was
front
never.
Entrance bufferings and things are definitely something. I would love to see the entrances look more appealing.
I mean, an example of something I'm curious about is the house next door to me burnt down. Today they're taking out all the landscape and they're bulldozing it. Is there a plan commission? Does it go before the Planning Commission to build that? There's nothing about it?
Just a single lot.
Building permit, yeah.
Building permit.
So how do they keep it to the standards of our?
Well, they would have to go by your subdivision.
Your homeowners association, yeah.
You have a HOA there?
There's no HOA.
We don't believe those in Fairview.
Hopefully, they're going to start.
We don't enforce them.
That's true. It's a fact.
Well, no, the individuals.
But you're letting somebody build a house.
No, what happened is y'all subdivision ended up, they didn't want to pay the fees, so y'all defaulted, and so it took it all out. Y'all dissolved it probably before you got there, but.
No, I was there. I watched the whole thing.
Oh, did you? I didn't know how long.
Did you quit paying?
Well, Brandon, do you know of any other city where the subdivisions come under that umbrella of?
Not that I can think of, but they certainly have their hand in entrances. One municipality we build in requires a certain amount of caliper be reinstalled on, when you get your CO, you have to have, I think it's, I can't even verbatim tell you, but they count the caliper of trees. You put a 3-inch in the front, they get 7.5 inches or something like that. They want to see back. Put a 3-inch in the front, and then they count your calipers on your bushes. So that's kind of a nice way to reinforce planting back in, to enforce, to make sure they have good landscaping, things like that. But particularly an umbrella over, they'll certainly look at an inventory, original inventory, and then you try and leave those outside buffer areas, certainly.
Well, you know, and when we came up with the approved tree and shrub list, the reason was is to prevent invasive species from, you know, and burning bush next door was, you know, Nandinas. Well, those are mainstays for those front entrances. And I think that's what, you know, we cannot go to a private a homeowner and say, you can't plant. You know, and I've always said this, you can insult somebody's mother and their dog before you talk about their landscape. They'll shoot you over it. So, but you can't do that. But we can, at least that part, which I consider public property.
We've been to multiple meetings before where they're requiring a 20-foot landscaping entrance because it was at a turn radius where headlights would hit the lot.
Right, so there are some code, codes and regulations for those front entrances,
absolutely.
Right? It's just nothing to do with the planting.
And not individual homes.
Well, no.
So here again, we need to hear that other cities are requiring this.
And these are all much larger, much sophisticated systems. And I think we're getting there. It's growing pains. I think we're heading in the right direction. I think we have a lot of good intentions. And Will Owen has been a huge help. He really has. He's very knowledgeable on it, and he has
Will's
great
good.
Intentions.
Yes, sir.
What Brandon's alluding to on these design review manuals and everything, our zoning ordinance, our subdivision regulations, our design review manual, none of them match each other. And that's what Will is trying to do. As Mayor was sitting in a meeting with him, and he'd give us a price of what it would take to do it. The time we couldn't afford it. So when he's not here for a staff review, or if he's not here for a planning commission meeting, he's supposed to be spending those hours developing one consistent viewpoint within what he considers is what we need. And some of these go back many years, back into the 90s when the state planner, Ron Cooper, as good as he was, he would write an ordinance for us. But it'd be the same thing that Hendersonville had, or Mount Juliet had, or Wilson County had.
We hope it's not the same Mount Juliet had.
Well, that's out of the the word Mount Juliet is out of them right now. So, but Frank saw some of this when he first come on. That's the reason we was having that codes review. Will started checking into it more after that and telling us how bad our regulations were. And so it's just going to take time for him to get it in line where we need it to have. And this is one of the things that's going to have to fall in place.
Well, here's my question. So when Will's doing all of this, and it, I mean, my concern is if these things aren't already in there, how do we make sure these things that need to be in there are in there? I mean, is he going through this book also and pulling stuff out?
Well, one of the things is when he sees something big, he's going ahead and bringing it forward instead of waiting until
right,
all the, like when we have to change. And this will be something we need to talk to, because this will be a big thing that we could probably go ahead and easily fix.
Brilliant.
But it's just, you know, one of those things that you can't fix it all at once, and there might have to still be tweaking when it gets done. Yeah.
So when is the workshop?
Next Tuesday.
The second Tuesday of May.
Second Tuesday of May.
Or Which we're in, there's a workshop next week in planning commission.
Yeah, that's right, we already had one, so we'd have to go.
Do another one, okay.
Do another one in May, and I'll get.
So are we invited to the one in May?
Yes, ma'am.
What's the date on that?
What's the date?
Second Tuesday.
I don't have my phone.
May, Tuesday, 10th.
And it's joint planning and tree, or?
Email out.
The 10th. That way I'll have Will and the attorney here, and we can have maybe an hour and a half workshop and try to get as much accomplished.
May 10th.
As we can.
May 10th. At what time?
May's gonna be busy.
It's 6.
Let's say 6 better off for everybody. I think it is for the mayor, too. Let's just say 6 to start with, you know, if we have to have a second.
Joint workshop with the planning commission, right?
When I asked Will about these tree ordinances, just so you know, he went all the way back to '97 and printed and talked about all these approved ordinances that ever happened to the tree and notated why and what, and he left it with the same thing we're talking about is, you know, I'll read what he wrote. "The landscaping tree issues are an aspect of city regulations that could benefit tremendously by consolidating all the various requirements found in multiple documents into a single comprehensive location, so that not only developers can clearly understand and abide, but the city can also understand and effectively enforce the regulations. This also allows for better oversight of future revisions or amendments, as you wouldn't have to go and look at the various documents where he has to go all the way back to '97 to locate what all's been done to it, to see the language of proposed amendments included in other documents in order to not be conflicting, so.
And we probably need to get all these updates to MTS for the state that have on record for Fairview, once we get them all.
Absolutely.
I think we can get MTS once Will gets through with it to consolidate them all.
Yeah, they do.
You know, I spoke with Will about this, going over these, all of this. Can't even fathom it. Good for him. I bet, man, he's.
He's, I think he's.
He's an asset for this.
He's a very big asset, and, you know, I depend on him quite a bit, but his knowledge amazes me every meeting.
I think he's passionate about the city of Fairview, too, and bettering us. He really, he'll call me and just talk about it, and just, I think he just enjoys talking about it. It's glad to have somebody that has that passion to wanna help us, because he doesn't live here, he lives in Murfreesboro.
Also, I think he sees something that can be brought.
Absolutely.
He likes it.
Well, and here's the thing, I still wouldn't mind the tree board being.
Commission.
Right before the planning commission, and having it right there. And if a planning commission person wanted to show up an hour early, or, you know, whatever, but there's no guarantee we can get through a meeting in an hour, and that's, you know, one of the problems. But idealistically, they should be going hand to hand.
We do have a planning commission person.
Mike, do you realize that you're an ex officio member of the planning commission?
There you go. Okay, wait a minute, we're sticking, we're going back to this. Okay, update on tree bank funds.
At least I need this first.
Oh, excuse me. '97, 748, 28.
But we're about to deplete it?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Any citizen comments?
What was the amount again, Mr. Moore?
'97, 748, 28.
How much did we earn this month?
$8 and something.
Hey, we're making money.
And does that include the payment for the trees, the other red buzz yet to?
We paid for the general fund right now.
Okay.
Once we get the roadscapes project taken care of, then Tom will take care of the bookkeeping part and put it back into the.
Okay.
Take it out of the tree bank fund. By the way, if you.
Is that all?
I'll talk to you after.
Okay, with no more citizen comments, we are adjourned.